Hola amigos, de nuevo Orlando Isaza con ustedes, dándole la bienvenida a nuestro programa semanal Vecinos Neighbors, que les trae los puntos de vista, las opiniones e imágenes de nuestra comunidad latina en el Valle Pionero. Hello there, this is Orlando Isaza, welcoming you to another edition of Vecinos Neighbors. This program brings you weekly the opinions, points of view and images from our Latino community in the Pioneer Valley. Today, we have a rather wonderful program in three segments. In the first segment, we will bring you some images from the Hispanic Family Festival last year, a talent show during that celebration, which will show you some of the abilities and talent of our youth in Holyoke. In the second segment, we will have some readings from a Cuban-American playwright, Dolores Prida, who presented her ideas and writings at a recent gathering of Latino writers at Heritage Park. And lastly, we will have a discussion with Jonathan Corman about a mural in the Phoenix Apartments in South Holyoke. So please stay with us. This is a wonderful program, and I certainly hope you enjoy it. El programa de hoy les viene en tres segmentos. En el primer segmento, vamos a ver imágenes del Festival de la Familia Hispana, donde nuestros jóvenes demostraron sus habilidades y su creatividad y su talento. En el segundo segmento, tendremos lecturas de la escritora cubano-americana Dolores Prida. Y en el tercer segmento, tendremos algunas de las opiniones y comentarios del señor Jonathan Corman acerca de un mural que ustedes quizá hayan visto en el sur de Holyoke, en los apartamentos Phoenix. Espero entonces que disfruten nuestro programa de hoy y que se diviertan. Gracias. No se vayan.
Olvídate todo, que tú para eso tienes experiencia. de emociones un día marché. De un mundo de sensaciones que no encontré. Y al descubrir que era todo una gran fantasía volví. Porque entendí que quería las cosas que viven en ti.
Adiós.
Ayúdame.
No hay nada más que hablar.
Piensa en mí.
Adiós.
¿Por qué?
Porque ahora soy yo la que quiere estar sin ti. Por eso vete, olvida mi nombre, mi cara, mi casa y pega la vuelta.
Jamás te pude comprender.
Vete, olvida mis ojos, mis manos, mis labios que no te desean.
Estás mintiendo, ya lo sé.
Vete, olvida que existo, que me conociste y no te sorprendas. Olvídate todo que tú para eso tienes de experiencia.
Por eso if you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer if you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on. And you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you.
Muchas gracias. Characters are called Ella and She. Ella always speaks Spanish, and she always speaks in English with his father, with which the culture has been complaining. This is a monologue. They're looking for something and she finds this worry bit. And she asks, do you know what regret means? And he just says, es una canción de Edith Piaf. She said, no. Regret means that time in Athens, many years ago, at a cafe where they played Yusufi music, the men got up and danced and brought glasses and small dishes against the tiled floor. The women did not get up and dance. They just watched and tucked their feet under the table, now and then shaking their shoulders to the music. One Greek man danced more than the others. He brought more glasses and dishes than the others. His name was Nikos. It was his birthday. He caught his hand with one of the glasses, but he didn't stop. He didn't pay any attention to this word. He kept on dancing. He danced by my table. I took a gardenia from the vase of the table and gave it to him. He took it, rubbed it on the blood dripping from his hand, and gave it back to me with a smile. He danced away toward the tables. I wanted to get up and break some dishes and dance with him. Dance away out the door into the street, all the way to some chic hotel by the harbor, where next morning I would hang the bed sheets thing with my clothes out of the window. But I didn't get up. Like the Greek women, I stayed on my seat, tapping my feet under the table, now and then shaking my shoulders to the music, a bloody gardenia wilting in my glass of red. And Ella says, no haber roto ni un plato. That's regret for sure. From my latest play, Botanica, the one that this man is going to give you money to This is a scene between Millie and Louis. Botanica is about three generations of women. The grandmother runs a botanica. We don't know what a botanica is. We sell these herbs and saints and all these Afro-Caribbean paraphernalia. People go for counsel on how to solve all their problems. Millie has just graduated from a fancy college in business administration. She has come back home. The grandmother thinks she's going to go to botanica, but Millie has no plans at all to do that. She's going to be vice president of Chase Manhattan. This is a scene between Millie and Ruben, who was like this guy who was sort of in love with her and he stayed behind in the neighborhood. And they talk about what he means by being from here or being from there. And Millie says, let me see. Ella le acaba de decir que no se va a quedar en la botánica. Y le dice, no logro hacerle entender que yo no soy parte de esto. Estas imágenes, estas creencias han sido parte del equipaje de otras generaciones, del África al Caribe, del Caribe a Nueva York. Pero yo soy de aquí, yo nací en Nueva York. Esto no es parte de mi equipaje. You know what I mean. Tú naciste aquí también, Rubén. ¿Tú entiendes lo que yo digo? Rubén le dice, no sé, yo veo las cosas de otra manera. Mira, no sé si te lo puedo explicar, si tengo las palabras. Yo no fui a una universidad tan fancy como la tuya. Yo la verdad me gradué de Hostos College en el Bronx. Y Millie le dice, tú también me echas en cara mi educación, Rubén. No es eso, no sé, mira. ¿Qué quiere decir ser de aquí? Pues, a mí, ser de aquí es mango y estroberis, alcapurrias y presos, yemayá y los yanquis. Yo no veo la diferencia. What's the big deal? Eso es lo que somos. Broche y fritanga. Kitsch y arroz con habichuelas, Chase Manhattan, la bolita. Todo depende de cómo tú empaques tu equipaje. Pero todo es parte de él. Todo es la misma cosa. You see, I decide what it means to be from here. Porque allá afuera hay muchos que piensan que aunque hayas nacido aquí y te cambien el nombre a Joe o Mimi, they think you're not from here anyway. Y los de allá, miren la isla de Puerto Rico, los de allá tampoco piensan que somos de allá. De aquí, de allá, qué sé yo. No hay por qué dejarlo todo atrás. No hay que dejar que nos maten tildaron a ver búfalos. Rubén, Alma, tú ves Pepe el Indio, un personaje de la calle que siempre anda con la cantaleta de que no hay que dejar que nos maten los búfalos. Rubén dice, Pepe el Indio es un hombre muy leído. Él dice que eso porque leyó que los indios americanos perdieron no solo sus tierras, sino también su cultura e identidad cuando el hombre blanco le mató a los búfalos. Mili, pero si no somos indios, Rubén. Él dice que cuando dejamos que nos malen las cosas que más nos importan, no somos más que tribus encerradas en reservaciones. Mira, mire lo que dice. Todo eso lo aprendiste en el oso, ¿no? ¿Eh? Él dice, pues sí. Will be into the little poems from T.S. Eliot. April is the coolest month, filling your heart with longing and desire. I'm sure that despite what everyone says, I've forgotten how to ride a bicycle. And now that spring is here, and I want to travel again, I have to walk. The next is to my cat, Eddie. And it begins with an excerpt from a poem by Pedro Salinas. No quiero tu libertad, no, ni tu fatiga, ni tus hojas muertas. Te quiero para soltarte, si tu destino soy yo, te está esperando. My querubin jumps over the fence, once more into the bridge in search of romance and adventure with the neighborhood cats. My heart jumps after him, but I make it come back and teach it again the old lesson it has yet to learn. That which is really yours will always return. Now this one is called, This Bot is for You. I wrote your name with every pen and pencil I own. 117 to be exact. I wrote your name in black and blue and green and red, in lead and ink, with ballpoints and number twos, at 3 o'clock in the morning. And since I didn't know what to do with 117 pictures of your name at that ungodly hour, I read the pages very, very carefully and saved the unbroken ashes in a little box. I have no idea what it means, those ashes in the box, but my 117 pens and pencils jumped out of their mugs and quite hysterically refused further cooperation, warning me not to fall in love with you. Thank God for the computer.
Well, I'm Jonathan Corman, and the Holyoke Mural Project, which I started a few years ago, together with a lot of people in the neighborhood who've been helping, and a lot of young people in the neighborhood who've been participating and painting, we decided we'd paint another mural this summer in Holyoke, and we chose this site because we thought it was especially nice that it was in a setting like this that's close to the housing and along a pathway and a place where people maybe will be doing some gardening later. And so that it's a slow place where people are stopping and doing things, and it'll decorate that area. And the things that we're always interested in painting a mural is to make a mural that's very beautiful, that will celebrate the neighborhood and the life of the community here, and also reflect the interests and needs and concerns and lives of all of us and people who live here. It always seems interesting working here that there's the experience of immigration and coming to the United States from somewhere else, and that seems like a very important theme in the community here, and so it's come into the murals that we painted in a few different ways. In this mural, we used a... we started from a story of that came from the mythology of the Taino Indians from Puerto Rico, before it was Puerto Rico. And with that story, we explored both the meaning of it and also the individual lives of some of the young people who were participating. So we talked a lot about the story and the different characters, and people told their own life story as they understood it as part of this journey that took place in this myth that we used. It included a lot of the things that you can see in the mural, like the boat and the passage across the ocean, and a river full of fish, and praying on a very high place for faith to overcome illness and to overcome sadness and homesickness, and then a return back to kind of coming together with the community at the very end of the story, which happened after they left the cave and then they returned to the cave. So maybe you could say the arches in the back symbolize the coming home to the cave that people left in the beginning of the story with this celebration and the marriage. In the middle of the mural, there's the children who in the story were left by a river, and when they cried, the sun turned them into frogs, because the sun saw that they were hungry and suffering. In our neighborhood, the kids don't get turned into frogs, but in the summertime, they play like frogs in the fountain, the spraying fountain off of Hamilton Street. So that's the central image. And at the top is the bird, who actually, in our story, one of the people who left the cave got turned into a singing bird. And it flies across the top of the mural, and it gives music to everyone who came after it. I guess everything else you can see for yourselves, and you know, if you keep looking at the mural like this, you can find lots of stories in it, and you can make up your own. All right.
Cesar Rosas from a group called Los Lobos. You might have heard of us. We made a movie a couple of years back called La Bamba. We had a big hit with that. And listen, I wanted to tell you guys, all you youngsters out there who are listening to me, you know, we're a group of musicians who went to school in East Los Angeles. We grew up there. And I can't stress how important it is for all of us to get a good education. I know that I went to college, and the rest of the guys who went to college, and we all learned music in college, and it's a very, very powerful tool. And I'd have to say that one of the reasons why we're here right now is because we've got a great education, and we use it now in our music, and we use theory, and it helps us out when we stumble, you know, come into a song, and we don't know what to do with it. We always go back to what we learned in school. And once again, I'd like to stress that in order for you to really make it out there and for you to be happy, we stress that please stay in school, graduate from high school, go on to college and get yourself a good education, and you will not go wrong. Thank you very much.
Espero entonces que nuestro programa de hoy haya sido de mucho placer para ustedes, espero que lo hayan disfrutado y espero que se unan a nosotros de nuevo la semana entrante con otro programa más de Vecinos, Neighbors. Please join us again next week with Vecinos, Neighbors, and I hope you enjoy today's program. Thanks again. Come back to us.